guys, welcome back to Sharman's Kitchen. I want to say a pleasant good night to each and every one of you. If you're visiting my channel for the first time, I would like to welcome you to my channel. Today, I'm celebrating 2 years on YouTube, and I want to say I feel so blessed and happy to meet so many beautiful people like you guys. Thank you so much for your love and support, and hope you guys will continue to stay, share those videos, and keep connected. So it's been a long journey, but a very wonderful, beautiful journey. Today I'm gonna be sharing a recipe for stew kingfish, because this is one of my favorite, and because it's my anniversary on YouTube, I choose to share this recipe with you guys. So come on down and let's get started. So I have the 5 beautiful pieces of kingfish here. And before I start anything else, I'm gonna season this fish. So we're gonna go in with some salt. And then we're gonna add some black pepper to that. A nice amount, and I'm gonna add some green seasoning, and my green seasoning contains of garlic, thyme, green onions, and pepper. So we're gonna add about 2 tablespoons, and I'm gonna mix all these ingredients in. So now that I finished seasoning the fish, I will leave it to sit about 15 minutes before I start frying them. Now we're gonna lightly dust the fish into some seasoned flour. And I have here a little bit of black pepper, a salt, and a little pinch of turmeric into that flour. You know what, I'm gonna go in with my hands, and then I'm gonna lightly dust the fish and just brush everything off, and then we will start frying these until they're nice and golden brown. I just finished frying the fish, and they look nice and beautifully done. So now I have some fresh ingredients chopped up. I have 1 large red onion. I have some garlic finely chopped. 1 marinate pepper finely chopped. I have some flat leaf parsley finely chopped. Some fine thyme, green onions. I'm gonna be adding 1/2 of a red bell pepper, a yellow one, and some shaved carrots for sweetness. And I have 2 marinate pepper that I'm just gonna add on top. And here, at the end of my stew, I'm gonna just garnish it with some cilantro, because that adds a really, really nice flavor to the stew. So I have a whole heap of fresh ingredients here. We're gonna start putting the stew together. So in the pan, I have about 1 tablespoon of coconut oil. I'm gonna be adding my red onion in here. And we're gonna start building flavor for the stew. So I'm gonna cook the onion until they're a little translucent before I add the next ingredient to the pot. Now that the onion has been cooking up a little, we're gonna add our garlic now into the pot, and our pepper, and some thyme, and that's the fine thyme. And I'm gonna be adding 1 cup of frozen green peas, and this will add some sweetness to the stew. So we're gonna mix that in, and we're gonna cook it until the peas is nice and glossy green. our peas is looking good, I'm gonna add some tomato paste. And this will give a nice flavor plus some color. And I'm gonna go in about 2 heaping tablespoons. We're gonna mix that in to take out some of the rawness. We'll cook it for a minute or so. So this is looking nice. I like the color that I'm seeing here. So now I'm gonna add my carrots in here. And this will also add sweetness. And my peppers, the bell peppers. We're gonna mix all this in. And these are some beautiful flavors, colors, and vegetables that we're adding to the stew. And now I'm gonna add some black pepper. Or I'm gonna grind a nice amount of black pepper. So now we're gonna mix this in. We're gonna add our salt now. Just about a teaspoon. And I will leave all the measurements in the description below. And I'm gonna add a little bit of Chinese spice. I love the flavor of the Chinese spice in the stew. This is optional. We're gonna mix that in. And then what I wanna do at this point, I'm gonna add about 2 cups of water in here. We wanna soften up these veggies a little. And it's gonna make a nice, beautiful sauce to rest the fish in. But before I do so, I like the colors that I'm seeing here right now. I'm gonna add a pack of Sazon powder. And this is actually a nice seasoning for stew. This is also optional, but I like the flavor of it. So today I'm gonna be adding 1 pack. It adds beautiful flavor and color to the stew. So now I'm gonna cover this down, leave it to cook for about 2 to 4 minutes so these vegetables can soften a little. And then we will add the fish back to this beautiful sauce here. Let's check on our stew sauce. Wow, the vegetables look nice. And the color of this sauce is so beautiful. I'm gonna add my flat leaf parsley in here. And we're gonna mix that in. I'm gonna add the green onions. We don't want it to cook too much, just to give that additional flavor at the end. And I have 2 beautiful marinate pepper. I'm gonna add to the pot our green onions. Mix this around. We're gonna put the heat on the lowest you can put it at this point. And then now we're gonna add those beautiful pieces of fish back to the pan. I like to cook the kingfish because it's a farm fish and it always hold up, doesn't break into pieces and loose up into the stew. So that's a nice fish to make stew or curry. And as usual, I always add more than what my pan can fit. So I will have to squeeze this piece in. We're gonna leave this here, the fish, about 5 minutes on the low heat to absorb some of this nice good juice and goodness. And then we will turn the stove off and serve up our dinner. Here is my beautiful kingfish stew, all done nicely and ready to serve up with some brown rice. I have 1 success story to share right after this. One of our viewer, Kavita, tried my recipe for stir fry veggies and she was very happy with the results. So right after this, I'm gonna show her success story. Keep those success stories coming because I love to hear when you guys try my recipe and love them. So let's get on to Kavita's success story. So here is that beautiful kingfish stew. Looks so delicious. I am actually drooling at the moment. So first of all, I'm gonna go in for some of the rice and I serve it with some brown rice and some of the gravy. And this bite is all my viewers and all my subscribers cheers. What a beautiful flavor and combination. The sweetness from the green peas and the carrots and the pepper really, really enhance the stew and all that fresh ingredients. Oh my God, with the flavor of that fried fish. Had to take another bite. And now I'm gonna dig into the fish because I wanna show you guys how it looks on the inside. This is a nice form fish, look at that. Nice and white in the inside and perfectly fried with that crust on the outside. And all that flavor is right under the skin. What a beautiful meal tonight to celebrate my 2 years on YouTube. So the other mouthful with the fish. So delicious. This stew can go with roti, bread. It can go with some boiled and fried provision, some dumplings, so many choices. Tonight I'm gonna sit down, enjoy my dinner. I wanna say to you guys, thanks for your love and support. Thank you for sticking out with me. And I wanna say stay blessed, stay safe. Bye for now.